I am going to the quantum theory, quantum technology. Quantum is, quantum means no large number. Quantum technology. Quantum technology is given now lot of priority nowadays. It's nothing that you are using a computer. There will be high speed computers. There will be very high speed computers. The idea is to develop the field of computer, and then the quantum technology is to increase speed of processing the information data of the computers, so that large number of data can be processed by the computer in shortest possible time and comes out with suggestions, predictions. For this, in the recent budget 2020 develop quantum mechanics. This is an emerging field that harnesses the laws of quantum mechanics to build powerful tools to process information. Speed, developing, increasing the speed, increasing the processing of information, and then increasing now using it many number of areas is the main motto of this national mission. Use of quantum phenomena, I will tell you. Normally, what is a natural computer and what is a quantum computer? That the difference I will tell you. Natural computer, information generally is processed or stored in normal computer in conventional bits. That means computer language has got no only is called a byte. A set of 8 bits is called a byte. Bit can be 0 or it can be 1. When there are 8, in 0, 1, likewise in 8 bits, many permutations, combinations can occur. 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, 0, 0, 0. Likewise, any number of combinations can occur. This is the variations, permutations, and combinations of 8 bits can happen many more times. One variation set of 8 bits is called a byte. 1,000 bytes, such bytes, are called 1 kilobyte, KB. 1,000 kilobytes is called 1 megabyte, MB. 1,000 megabytes is called 1 gigabyte, GB. The data, each network facilitator gives you 1 GB data every day. What is 1 GB? 1 GB is, I told you, 1,000 megabytes, or 1,000 into 1,000 kilobytes, 1,000, likewise, this much information is 1 GB. Each bit in a byte is a switch. They call it switch also. What happens when you, information is getting stored either in 0 or 1, blinking of the switches happens in the processor. 8 such bits combination is a byte. This way, the entire information is getting stored in normal computer. It can be, I tell you one thing very clearly, you understand. The information in normal computer can be stored either as 0 or 1. Only two forms. This is called a conventional bit. Quantum computer, what happens? The bit is called, is not a conventional bit. Here the bit is called a qubit, quantum bit. Qubit, the principle is, here one more dimension is getting added to the bit. You observe carefully. Here information can be stored either one, either zero, or one, or in between zero and one, or both. How strange it is. It can be zero, it can be one, it can be in between, or it can be both. It can be both. That means now another two dimensions are added to 8 bits. That means instead of 8 single bits, 8 4 dimensions are added to each bit. Now 8 into 4, 32. 32 variations in a 8-bit is giving you 1 byte. A normal computer, 8 bits is 1 byte. Here, 8 bits of 4 variations is giving you 1 byte. When more number of bits are increasing, dimensions are increasing, variations increase by 4 times, automatically the number of calculations the computer can make in each variation, number increases, speed increases, fastness increases, many calculations comes out now to limited time. That is the quantum. That means computers work faster. This all entire process is going towards supercomputer. I'll tell you what is a supercomputer when I tell that. But here entire information is getting processed really faster because the variations are increasing. Understand. Quantum computer, quantum can be bits in, see here, variations I told you, qubit I told you, and then no, how the information can get stored in 4 variants. Scientist Schrodinger comes out with the suggestion that the quantum mechanics will work almost contradictory to the Newton's mechanics. Newton's mechanic in Heisenberg uncertainty principle, what it says, when a particular atom is, or subatom is in momentum with a speed in a particular a space, given any time, you can either calculate the speed of the particle or place of the particle, not both. Suppose an electron is orbiting, is now moving very fast in the set orbital. In that, either you can predict electron's speed, or in that particular moment, you can clearly, accurately find out where the electron could be. Not both. That is the Heisenberg's uncertainty principle. Now, another scientist called Schrodinger, he comes out with another statement. Here, you can correlate. I say the information can be stored either in 0 or 1. It is accurately following the Newtonian principle or Heisenberg's uncertain principle. It can be 0 or it can be 1. It cannot be both. But Schrodinger comes out a statement. The same time, when it is moving, subatom particle up to atoms, that works out in the subatomic level, when it is particle is moving in with a speed and in a set moment, you can identify both. The particle can be here, can be there, can it be at the anywhere. It can be anywhere in a particular closed circuit. It can be here, it can be there. The particle can be anywhere within that. That means it is possible. There need not be, you cannot set that particle to one particular place. It can be anywhere. That is, the number of variants are getting more here. Like Schrodinger's in variants, I told you in a quantum bit. Similar thing is happening in Schrodinger's principle. Schrodinger is the first scientist who propagated quantum dynamics, quantum laws. Quantum law is nothing but no, this is it is not a set. It is against the Heisenberg's uncertainty principle, which is based on Newton's laws. Ministry of Environment and Information Technology, with association of Amazon Web Services, AWS, is setting up a quantum computing lab with the funds being given by the Government of India, as 8,000 crores are allocated in the recent budget for establishment of a quantum computing lab. Quantum computing lab is functioning under Ministry of Environmental and Information Technology of India and Amazon Web Services. It is as a government initiative. It will be developed. Even DST, Department of Science and Technology, has got a purview over it. It is a source created by the government for governmental organizations utilizing the resources, academicians, and then research people and developers of supercomputing technique. Entire thing is within the purview of this supercomputing lab. It enables advances in healthcare, aerospace, agriculture, production technology, etc. It gives access to quantum development environment. It can be private, it can be government, anywhere, any work is going on towards quantum computing. Now, this facility is a best resource for anybody to go and work there to develop it. It is the world's first quantum computing lab aligned with the help of Amazon Web Services. Nowhere in the world, any government hasn't started a quantum computing lab. Normal computers, I told you, a necessity has come to increase the combination of the bits more than a limit in the same size chip. I tell you one thing, in a chip, there can be a limited number of processors can be placed in a chip. Each processor is a small thing, it is called a switch. I told you 1010 like that, everything is a switch, but there is a limit because of the size of the smallness of the processor, each chip can accommodate only certain number of processors. The number which can be accommodated on a chip or the number of processors or switches accommodated on a chip is called a Fermi limit. F-E-R-M-I limit. Fermi limit. Schrodinger has proposed two laws. This is referred to quantum computing. Whenever you think about quantum computing, two laws of Schrodinger's apply in quantum dynamics, quantum computing. One is superposition. I told you the particle can be anywhere. It need not be limited to a place. It can be anywhere. That is called, he called it a superposition. That is one thing. Second principle is entanglement. Remember entanglement. Entanglement is nothing but assume there are two boxes, sealed boxes. In each box, a decaying radioactive material is placed. As material gets decayed, the weight of that reduces. When a rate reduces to a particular level, a lid in a poisonous gas, which is closed, will get open. Suppose 1 gram of radioactive material you have placed. In half an hour, it reduces to 0.5 gram. When it reaches 0.5 gram, the lid of the poisonous bottle gets opened, poison comes out. There is a live cat placed in the box, cat gets killed. If Newton principle is working in this way, this has to happen exactly like this. Similar box is kept in another place. Entire same thing is there. That means in these two boxes, there are only two possibilities. At a probability principle, four such boxes are placed. Two at 50% probability, in two boxes the cat can be live, in two boxes the cat can be dead. Understand?
Sir, can we join again, sir? The meeting will end.
Another 5 minutes, madam?
Yes, right. Sir. Yes, sir. Yeah. Okay. Please join students. This is a recurring meeting ID. You can join once again.